वट इज जोहो बुक? जोहो बुक इज अ अकाउंटिंग सॉल्यूशन फॉर बिजनेस. सो फर्स्ट आई गिव यू अ ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट जोहो बुक. जोहो बुक इज अ क्लाउड बेस्ड अकाउंटिंग प्लेटफॉर्म. इट इज यूज बाय स्मॉल एंड मीडियम बिजनेसेस टू मैनेज देयर फाइनेंसेस. लाइक येस्टरडे ब्लेसी गेव अस द प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन जोहो पीपल दैट वॉज यूज फॉर ह्यूमन HRMS. सेम जोहो बुक इज यूज फॉर द अकाउंटिंग पर्पज. Now, what are the features of Zoho Book? It has a dashboard that is user-friendly and easy to understand. Item management, banking integration, sales and invoicing, purchases and expense tracking, time tracking, comprehensive reports, document management, automation and customization. So first, I'll discuss about dashboard. Now, what this dashboard of Zoho Book includes, it gives you a overview about the financial health of your business. What are the components? It gives you a brief about the cash flows, what money is coming in and what money is going out from your business. What are your expenses, income from your business? What are the top expenses? Sometimes we expend too much in the business for some particular service, goods, or any other expenses which we made. What are outstanding amounts which we owe? It means which we have to pay to our clients and which our clients has to pay to us. Because sometimes we have clients and sometimes for us, sometimes we are clients for some other party, for the vendors. So it gives you these kind of information, the cash flow, what are income expense expenditures and the amounts at receivables and payables. It gives you a brief summary in the form of charts and graphs. Maybe most of you spend or have investment in mutual funds. So when you log in your dashboard or mutual funds, so it gives you a brief, about in form of charts about your investment. So same it will do in form of the charts and graphs, the financial health of your business. Just I'll give you a brief. Just wait. Like this. When you open your login your Zoho Book account, there is total receivables. It means what amount is due to your clients and total payables which you have to pay to your which you have to pay to your vendors. It means for those parties for whom you are the clients. So this is about the dashboard. Now next feature of Zoho Book is items, goods and services. So it includes Zoho Book provides you the facility to add the goods and the services as well. It means what are the types of services you have. You can name them. You can give the description, product and service catalog, inventory management, batch and expiry tracking, pricing and taxation. It means Zoho Book gives you the facility to add your items or the products and services which you are going to sell with the brief description, with the prices and the images for those respective products. Inventory management, it means the stock level of the goods and the services or the goods and the products which you are selling to your clients. So according to that, according to the sales and purchase in real time basis, it will adjust the inventory or the stock level of those goods automatically. Batch and expiry tracking, monitor batch numbers and expiration dates for perishable goods. Pricing and taxation. So you can assign the different prices for different services or for different goods according to the their as per your requirement and the tax rates as well, because each region has different tax rates and each region has different rules and regulation and compliances. So according to that, Zoho Book by default it fetch the tax rates. Third is banking. In Zoho Book you can secure the secure bank connection. You can link your bank accounts and credit cards for securely. That is totally safe. It means you can link the Zoho in Zoho Book your bank accounts and the credit cards which you can use to pay to your vendors or the bank account details that how much amount or how much transactions you have made. Automatic transaction import. It means once you have imported the bank statement in Zoho Book, so it will automatically update the bank transactions as well. Transaction categorization. मैच बैंक ट्रांजेक्शन विद एग्जिस्टिंग रिकॉर्ड्स, क्रिएट बैंक रूल्स फॉर ऑटोमेटिक कैटेगराइजेशन. इट मीन्स यू कैन कैटेगराइज योर बैंक ट्रांजेक्शंस. इट मीन्स दैट व्हाट आर योर, यू कैन नेम दैम ऑन द बेसिस व्हाट आर योर एक्सपेंसेस इन योर बैंक ट्रांजेक्शंस एंड व्हाट आर योर इनकम्स. बैंक रिकंसाइलेशन, बैंक रिकंसाइलेशन मीन्स वंस यू इम्पोर्ट द बैंक स्टेटमेंट इन जोहो बुक, सो यू कैन मैच द बैंक स्टेटमेंट डिटेल्स विद योर जोहो बुक ट्रांजेक्शन. यू कैन मैच दैट ये दिस मच अमाउंट आई हैव पेड एंड दिस मच ट्रांजेक्शन इज शोइंग इन जोहो बुक. सो इट विल हेल्प यू, यू नो, इन अवॉइडिंग द डिस्क्रिपेंसीज दैट येस वेयर इज द, यू नो, डिफरेंस इज कमिंग. सो दैट इज टोटली ऑटोमेटिकली डन बाय द जोहो बुक. सो इट हेल्प्स यू इन अवॉइडिंग द एनी काइंड ऑफ द डिस्क्रिपेंसीज वंस यू हैव. बट फॉर दिस यू हैव टू इम्पोर्ट योर बैंक स्टेटमेंट एंड क्रेडिट कार्ड डिटेल्स टू जोहो बुक अकाउंट, जोहो अकाउंट, जोहो बुक्स. अनादर फीचर इज सेल्स मॉड्यूल. सी एज वी हैव आर क्लाइंट्स, सो वी हैव टू रजिस्टर दोज क्लाइंट्स इन द जोहो बुक. इनवॉइसिंग, वॉट आर द फीचर्स इन सेल्स मॉड्यूल इट सेल्फ? इनवॉइसिंग, एस्टिमेट्स, कस्टमर रिलेशनशिप मैनेजमेंट, पेमेंट प्रोसेसिंग, रिटेनर इनवॉइसिस एंड रिकरिंग इनवॉइसिस. सो फर्स्ट इन जोहो बुक वी हैव टू क्रिएट द डिटेल्स ऑफ द कस्टमर्स. द डिटेल्स इट मीन्स वी हैव टू रजिस्टर द क्लाइंट दैट यस दीज आर माई क्लाइंट्स एंड आई हैव टू रजिस्टर दैम इन द जोहो बुक. इट इंक्लूड्स देयर नेम, एड्रेस, द शिपिंग एड्रेस, बिलिंग एड्रेस, द करेंसी इन विच दे आर डीलिंग. यू कैन यू नो कस्टमाइज द करेंसी, द टैक्स रेट्स एज पर द कंट्री एज वेल. देर आर सो मेनी ऑप्शंस इन द करेंसी. Once you have created the customer details, the customer relationship management, then when you have to sell any goods or services, then you have to create an estimate. It means you will create a performa invoice. So in that performa invoice, the name, the client, which you have already registered in your client relationship management, in that details will be automatically fetched at the time of the performa invoice. Invoicing, yes, there are different templates available according to your brand, which you can customize according to your brand. You can directly email those invoices to your clients. Set up multilingual and multi-currency invoices, which I have already discussed, that according to the client, that if the client is inside, you know, in India, or if the client is in another country, so according to the client, you can change the currency as well. Once we have created the performa invoice and the client has made the payment, then we can convert that performa invoice into the tax invoice, right? And again, that tax invoice is easily, you know, you can send the tax invoice via email to your client because you already have those details saved in your Zoho books. Payment processing, yes, we have integrated with payment gateways. There are PayPal, Stripe, and other payment sources as well. Your client can pay online. Retainer invoice, request upfront payments for services. Recurring invoices, it means you know, there are some services which are subscription based. So in those services, you can automatically in Zoho Book, you can say that yes, these services are automatic and you can easily on timely basis, those bills can be easily time to time basis will be sent to your client because the details which you have already saved in your Zoho books. Now purchase model. As sales model is used for your clients, now purchase model you will use for your vendors. Vendors means for whom you are the client. Okay. Now bills and vendor payments, expense tracking, vendor management, purchase order and recurring expenses. So bills and vendor payments, it means you can record the bills and track due dates. Bills and vendor payments, it means the bills, what goods you want from your vendor, you can ask, you can make up invoice according to that. And once they have delivered the goods and services to you, you can send them the bill as well. Schedule payments and set reminders. Yes, what are the payments which you have to make? You can set the reminders accordingly so that you will not miss your any of your payment to your vendors. Expense tracking, log daily expense with or without receipts. categorize expense for their better analysis. There are some expenses which are not which do not need to be make bill of those expenses. Like there are some expenses like travel expenses. So for those you will not make any bill. You will add them in the expense tracking and make receipts accordingly. Vendor management, as for our client, we make a customer relationship management. So for our vendors as well, we maintain a vendor management in which we save the details that yes, these are my vendors from whom I can get the services. Same, the name, the address, and the shipping address, the other communication details as well. Purchase order, create and send purchase order to suppliers. Convert purchase order into bills upon receipt. It means first you will create a purchase order that you will ask them to supply the goods and services to you. Once they have supplied those products to you, then you will make a bill after receiving those goods and services. Recurring expenses. As in sales module, we have a recurring as we have recurring invoices, so same with the purchase module, we have recurring expenses. So that we can, there are some expenses which are recurring time to time, which we have to pay, like rent and utilities. So we can set the reminder, and by default, automatically it will deduct from your account itself. Another feature is time tracking. Time tracking is used by those businesses who charge from their clients on the basis of the services which they provide on the basis of the time or the hours. Suppose if a person is charged on service providing a services which generally charged on the basis of hours, like we use Toggle with us. So it is more or less same, but on the basis of those reports, you can charge from your client that yes, this much hours I have we have to make a project. On the basis of that, we work on those projects with some log entries, and we can share with our client that yes, this much time I have spent on this project, this much hours, and accordingly you can ask for the payment from your client. Log time entries record the amount of time spent working on specific projects. Assign tasks to projects. You can assign the task within the project to your team members, which make easy to track what are the billable hours and non-billable hours. Billing for time. Convert billable hours into invoices. It means those hours which you have spent on a particular project for a specific the project which you have with your client. So you can make the invoices for that particular time logs. Timers, use built-in timers for accurate time tracking. In time tracking in Zoho Books, there is an option to pause the time as well. So whatever time you are giving for that specific project, you have the option that yes, this much time I have given to your project, this much hours, and accordingly you can charge to your client. Another feature is reports and analytics. Though this is an accounting software, so definitely it will have a financial statement, tax reports, and sales and purchase reports. So financial statement, it includes P&L statement. You can fetch the P&L of your company, that what are the income and expenses over a period of time which you have spent in your business. Balance sheet, what are the assets and liabilities, which shows the liquidity of your business. Cash flow statement, that how much money coming in and how much amount goes out from your business. So the money movement analysis, these financial reports you can easily fetch from Zoho Books. Tax reports, prepare for tax season with comprehensive summaries, track collected and paid tax. On the timely basis, how much tax you have paid and how much tax you have paid to you. All this information is saved in Zoho Books. So at the time of filing the tax, it will be easy for you to fetch the data and file your tax accordingly on each and every financial year or as per your requirement. Sales and purchase report, analyze customer purchases and vendor expenses, that how much sales you have made and how much purchases you have done from your vendors. So all these three to four kind of reports you can easily get from the Zoho Books. इन्वेंट्री रिपोर्ट्स विच आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड दैट हाउ मच स्टॉक लेवल विथ यू एंड व्हाट इज द वैल्यूएशन दैट हाउ मच स्टॉक ऑफ द गुड्स एंड प्रोडक्ट्स विच यू हैव द व्हाट इज द करंट वैल्यू ऑफ दोज गुड्स अकॉर्डिंगली बिकॉज एज वेन यू बाय एंड वेन यू आर सेलिंग अ गुड और प्रोडक्ट सो ऑन ऑटोमेटिकली इट विल चेंज इन योर जोहो बुक एज वेल सो इट विल बी ईजी टू मॉनिटर द स्टॉक लेवल्स कस्टमाइजेबल रिपोर्ट्स फिल्टर सॉर्ट एंड कस्टमाइज रिपोर्ट टू सूट योर नीड्स स्केड्यूल्ड रिपोर्ट्स ऑटोमेट रिपोर्ट जनरेशन एंड ईमेल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑटोमेटिकली यू कैन दो एवरीथिंग इज ऑटोमेटिकली डन इन जोहो बुक सो ऑटो इट विल ऑटोमेटिकली जनरेट द रिपोर्ट्स एंड इट हैज द फैसिलिटी टू ईमेल टू योर क्लाइंट्स सो यू कैन देन यू सो दैट यू कैन ईजिली ईमेल टू योर क्लाइंट्स एज वेल Now, mobile access, yes, Zoho Book is easily available. It has an app. It is easily available for iOS and Android. You can manage the finances anytime and anywhere. Features on mobile, you can send the invoices, you can scan the invoices, record the expenses, and view reports in mobile app using the Zoho Book application. Real-time sync. As the data is updated instantly, it will be updated in all the devices on real-time basis. So, mobile, you can easily access Zoho Book on mobile. Why to choose Zoho Book? It simplifies, as you know, it simplifies complex accounting tasks. It is a scalable accounting, scalable solution for growing businesses. It means, as per the technology changes, it has all the features according to the technological environment or requirement. So you can easily grow your business needs and you can fulfill your business needs accordingly. Enhances financial visibility and decision making, though it helps you in avoiding the discrepancies. It has a time tracker facility for your in which through which you can charge from your clients. So it has a client financial visibility and you can easily make decisions that yes, where your business is standing right now. So this is that's it from my side. And now there is a brief tutorial about Zoho Book that how Zoho Book works.
Zoho Books tutorial for
Is the
beginners.
video audible?
Yes, Neha.
Yes,
Okay.
yes, Neha.
Hi guys, welcome back. Today I'm going to be showing you how you
Yes,
can
it's
easily
audible.
invoices.
As I already told you that what is dashboard, so this is how the cash flow is showing in this dashboard that yes, it is at some point it is going down somewhere there is a saturation point. So that's how the what are the total receivables and total payables it is showing. It is giving you the brief summary in the form of graphs and charts that yes, where your business is standing, how much you have to pay, and how much your client has to pay to you.
Let me have a price. So the price is my, this is my currency that I have actually added. And you can change your currency anytime you like from settings.
So here we can change the currency according to our product that where we have to sell our product or service.
I am going over. This is actually a journal. I can add different expenses in Zoho. And a new item will be created on Zoho. So this is my item here. Now I will be able to check my transactions. If I want to perform more actions, I can go to more and I can clone it, delete it, go to add your bank. We can add any kind of bank, any kind
This
of
is
credit
how you
card
can add your
as
bank.
well. So if you have any tokens, you can also search for it. You can also search for a different account. If you want to enter one manually, you can do so too. That's really easy. Here and create a brand new customer. Click on new, and then I will.
In new customer, we have when we create a new customer, we have two options, business and individuals. Accordingly, we can select that. We will fill the name of the primary person to whom we have to connect, the name of the company if this is a business, and if it is individual, then definitely it is the name of the concerned person or our name of the client. The some basic information like email, phone number, the address which you the shipping address, the billing address. Once you will create this customer, it will saved in your Zoho Book account.
Done.
It will be easy to make the invoices, both the pro forma invoice
could create an individual custom Smith just for consumer. I can add a comment, an important option that we have. So to create a new invoice, just click on this new option and it will allow you to create a brand new invoice. So this is where we create a new invoice. If I want to change the name, I can. First, we have to select a custom. So that's
Like
why I
this,
wanted to
in
show
this
you.
video, the person has created already registered a customer with the name of Adam Smith. If you have already n number of clients in your Zoho Book account register in your Zoho Books, so it will show you all the details of the customer. You can select the name of the client or the customer. It will automatically fetch the billing details, the shipping address which you have saved at the time of creating the customer. You have to fill the name. You have to give your invoice number, fill the invoice number. If you have any salesperson, you can mention the name of the salesperson while creating the pro forma invoice. And in this as well, you have the information of what are the details.
How to create
Please.
customer so that we can create an invoice. It's going to be my invoice number, which is one, order name. So you can click here, and it's going to be this. It is going to be till the subject for services. Now we have to select an item. We can add another line if there are two products. If there are more, then I could just add more and more lines, and then we can just get rid of them. I'm going to click right here, and it will allow me add a new item, or maybe I can select from the item that I already created. So we created this test item, which was 59 pounds. It's right here. This is the quantity. And now you can see right here, because the client that I selected, I gave them the currency Canadian dollars. So you can
See here, she mentioned GBP, but here in India we will use rupee. So with us, there is one more option will come, that is GST. So it will automatically fetch if the client, according to the interstate or intrastate, it will automatically change the percent or the GST percentage. Okay, so in for our country, in India, it will automatically calculate the GST rate for you according to the address of the client.
see right here, now they're converting, the rate is right here. They're converting this for us. I would this is the code easily add discounts, and I can email that I just added. You can see right here, this is the email, and this is my email, and this is the invoice right here, very where I can create different projects, and then I can track time for these projects on Zoho Books. We have time sheets, accountant, in accountant, we have. And Zoho is all-in-one platform, very good for finance and accounting when it comes to your business. So if you're looking for a platform that allows you to create invoices, track time, add budgets, get accountants reports, then you should definitely check out Zoho Books.
So that's it from my end.